Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
In this video, we're going to talk about opening and saving databases and objects. In Access, this works a little bit differently from other programs like Word or Excel, and it's important that you know how it works before you start editing databases. We'll start by opening a database. Make sure you're in Backstage View, then click Open. And if there are any recently opened files, they'll appear here. But if you don't see the one you're looking for, just click Browse. And then you can double-click your file to open it. Now you may get a warning message here, so if you trust the source of the database, then click Enable Content. Now earlier I mentioned that Access is a little bit different from other programs, and that's because you're not going to be editing the database itself, but rather the objects within the database. Access treats each one of these objects as separate documents, and each one can be opened, saved, and closed individually. So you can think of the database as just a folder of different objects. Let's open a few objects. Just double-click on each one, and I'm going to open a table, a query, and I think I'll also open a form, and a report. Each of these objects now has a tab on the Document Tabs bar. If you make any changes, you'll need to save the object before you close it. You can do that by clicking Save on the Quick Access toolbar. And this only saves the current object. And to close it, you can click the X over on the right. If you need to rename an object, you can just right-click the name in the navigation pane and select Rename. And then type whatever name you want. To close the database, click the File tab and select Close. And in Access, you're not going to be saving your database because you're saving each object individually. And this may seem a little bit strange at first, but as long as you remember to think of the database as a folder of objects, then you'll be okay.